As the country continues to face an overdue reckoning with white supremacy, America is rethinking the way it glorifies slavery. NASCAR banned the Confederate flag, HBO Max removed Gone with the Wind, and Lady Antebellum is now just Lady A. Guys, abbreviating your band name won't make people forget what it originally stood for. People are still fully aware that ABBA used to stand for All Bitches Be Acting Crazy. The sea is silent. But while some racist shit is going away, one thing that isn't is the way the Republican Party punishes black and brown voters for just wanting to vote.
On Tuesday, many waited for hours to vote during Georgia's primary elections. The wait seemed especially long in counties with large African-American populations. Dozens of polling stations were closed because of coronavirus concerns. Many voters were sent home.
Look, I know things move at a slower pace in the South. It was just last week some Southerners found out they lost the Civil War. But no one should have to wait hours to cast their ballot, especially as we're approaching an election that could open the seventh seal. This year, Georgia, in an attempt to answer for accusations of voter suppression during its 2018 governor's race, rolled out new touchscreen voting machines statewide. The result? Georgia managed to suppress the vote even more. Poll workers were given limited training on the new machines, and some churches and schools declined to act as polling places due to fears of coronavirus spread. Those problems, combined with absentee ballots that were never delivered, resulted in a total cluster. The only way Georgia's primary could have gone any worse is if the whole time a guy was standing behind you in line going, "You know, it's not the heat, it's the humidity." This is a terrifying indicator for what's in store for November, especially because for the first time in a generation, Georgia is a battleground state for the presidential election. The last time Georgia was in play for the Democrats, we were all drinking Crystal Pepsi. Crystal Pepsi, the other vile tradition to come from the South. But voter suppression isn't just limited to Georgia. The message we hear from everyone, and the one I give on this show, is that if we want to change things, we have to go vote. But it's not always that simple. Republicans work incredibly hard to make voting difficult, especially for voters who are black, indigenous, or people of color. Republicans' key voting block is older, whiter people who are one heartbeat away from the great Cracker Barrel in the sky. Meanwhile, the overall electorate has become more diverse and more likely to reject campaign promises that sound like they come from the most uncomfortable parts of Splash Mountain. You guys have hundreds of movies. Choose a theme that's not racist. Even a ride based on Up would be okay. I mean, like, it would be sad, but it would be better than Song of the South. Republicans' base is shrinking. It's in their best interest to keep young people, people with disabilities, and people of color who tend to vote progressively from voting. And as seen last week in Georgia, they are amazingly good at it. How are Republicans still getting away with this? To answer that question, we have to look back to the bygone anti-antebellum era of 2013, when the Supreme Court's landmark decision on Shelby County versus Holder gutted the Voting Rights Act of 1965. According to the opinion written by Chief Justice John Roberts, elements of the VRA that protected black and brown voters were no longer needed because, he implied, our country has successfully wiped away so much of its racist past. It was easily 2013's most upsetting decision, which is impressive considering that same year, Michael Douglas decided to claim that he ate so much pussy it almost killed him. Now that is a disclosure I don't need. I mean, talk about the game. Falling down. More like going down. Michael Douglas has a fatal attraction to pussy. He should have had the basic instinct to use a dental dam. He was in Ant-Man, but he was also in your aunt, man. The Kaminsky Method. If you liked this video, hit subscribe and let me know in the comments below. And if you didn't like this video, I'm sure you've already left a comment. Thank you so much.